How to use your L300 HVG. Previously, we have discussed the L200 HVG. And this video will show the other rotating laser level, which is very similar with our L200 HVG. The L300 HVG is the latest model from the same series. It is endowed with more functions and has more operability. The exterior working range can be up to 800 m, 2624 ft in diameter with detector. Accuracy of ±1/8 at 100 ft. We're gonna have a detailed explanation of the specific operation in this video. Let's start with the basics. Battery installment and power on off. Rotate counterclockwise is shown, and turn on the battery compartment. Install the battery, and rotate clockwise to tighten the compartment. Press the key on, off to turn on automatic leveling in default. The power indicator will light. Press the key on, off again to switch off the instrument. The power indicator will go out. Automatic leveling mode. Press the key on, off to bring automatic leveling function. It takes about 15 seconds. The laser module will rotate at the speed of 600 RPM in default. The indicator and beam S will blink together. If the instrument is placed improperly, or the slope of instrument exceeds the range phi, please adjust the position or angle of the instrument. Spinning. Press the key to control the spinning speed of the laser module. Press the button repeatedly. The spinning speed of the laser module will continuously change as follows: 0, 200, 600, 0 RPM. Scanning. Press the key to change the spinning speed to 0 revolutions per minute. Press the key repeatedly. The angle of scanning will continuously change as follows: 0 degrees, 10 degrees, 45 degrees, 90 degrees, 180 degrees. Return to 0 degrees. Slope adjustment. When the instrument is applied for horizontal scanning, the slope of x-axis and y-axis can be set. Press the key. The instrument enters the manual leveling mode. The indicator will light. Slope of x-axis. In the X1, beam to the direction of the slope required then to adjust. Press the key. To move the laser beam up or down, exit slope adjustment mode. Press key. Again, the instrument will exit the slope adjustment mode and will self-leveling again. The indicator will go out. ADS. After powering on, in self-leveling mode, press the button to turn on ADS mode. In ADS mode, if the tool is moved during work, it will stop rotating, and the ADS button prompt light will slow flash to remind. Vertical leveling. Place the unit on the rear lay down mount on a firm, generally level surface. The mount is located on the opposing side of the keypad. Press the button, and the unit will power on and begin automatically self-leveling vertically. This process takes around 15 seconds. When the leveling process is completed, the laser will start spinning at 600 revolutions per minute in default, indicating a vertically leveled atom. Accuracy check. Checking the leveling accuracy, apart from exterior influences, device-specific influences, such as heavy impact or falling down, can lead to deviations. Therefore, check the accuracy of the instrument each time before starting your work. A free measuring distance of 100 ft 30 meters on a firm surface is required for the check. A reversal measurement must be carried out over both axes X and Y, each positive and negative, for complete measurements. Mount the instrument in a horizontal position onto a tripod, or place it on a firm and level surface near wall. Switch the instrument on. Position the X-axis to aim to a wall or target plane. After the leveling, mark the center of the laser beam on wall point H1. Rotate the instrument by 180 degrees. Allow it to level in and mark the center point of the laser beam on the wall point H2. The difference D of both marked points H1 and H2 on wall is the actual deviation of the instrument for the measured axis. The value of D deviation should be less than 1/4 in 6 millimeters. Repeat the measuring procedure for the y-axis. Position the y-axis to aim to a wall or target plane. After the leveling, Mark the center with the laser beam on wall point H1. Rotate the instrument by 180 degrees. Allow it to level in and mark the center point of the laser beam on the wall point H2. The difference D of both mark points H1 and H2 on wall is the actual deviation of the instrument for the measured axis. The value of the deviation in either axis should be less than 1/4 in 6 mm. Checking the vertical alignment, mount the instrument in a vertical position onto a tripod. Using mount accessory or place it on a firm and level surface near wall. Switch the instrument on. Position the up beam to aim at wall A or target plate. After the leveling, mark the center of the laser beam on wall A point H1. Rotate the instrument by 180 degrees. Allow it to level and mark the center point of the laser beam on wall B point H2. Without turning the instrument, position it close to wall B by moving the tripod. After instrument levels, align the height of the instrument so that the center point of laser beam is exactly on point H2 of wall B. Rotate the instrument by 180 degrees without changing the height. Allow it to level and mark the center point of the laser beam on wall A point H3. The mark of point H3 should be marked in such a way that it is as vertical as possible above or below point H1. The difference D of both marked points H1 and H3 on wall A is the actual deviation of the instrument for the measured axis. The value of the deviation should be less than 1/4 in 6 mm. Remote control. Indicator. Rotating speed selection. Manual, slope mode. Scanning mode. Anti-clockwise spin. Clockwise spin. Manual slope X and Y axis. Function. Spinning. Continuous spinning. Press the button to control the spinning speed of the laser module. Press the key repeatedly. The spinning speed of the laser module will continuously change as follows. 0, 300, 600, 0 RPM. Stepping spinning. Press the button to change the spinning speed to 0 RPM. Press the button, the laser beam will step move clockwise. Press the button, the laser beam will step move counterclockwise. Scan mode. Press the button to change the spinning speed to 0 RPM. Press the button repeatedly. The angle of scanning will continuously change as follows. 0 degrees, 10 degrees, 45 degrees, 90 degrees, 180 degrees. Return to 0 degrees. Slope adjustment. Press the button. The instrument enters the manual leveling mode. Slope of x-axis. In the X1, beam to the direction of the slope required then to adjust. Press the button to move the laser beam up or down. Slope of y-axis. In the Y1, beam to the direction of the slope required then to adjust. Press the button. Or to move the laser beam up or down. Slope of both X and Y axis. Proceed as above, then use over arrow buttons as required. Exit slope adjustment mode. Press the button again. The instrument will exit the slope adjustment mode and will self-leveling again. Before the end, let's do a quick review of all of the buttons. On off button. Slope adjustment buttons in 10 plus axis. Manual, slope mode button. Manual, slope mode indicator. Edge mode indicator. Edge button. Variable rotation speed button. Slope adjustment buttons in X axis. Power on indicator. Battery capacity indicators. Scanning angle selection. Laser window. Control keypad. Type-C charging port. 5/8, 11 threaded mount. Window for plumb beam. Battery compartment. Battery indicator. Type-C charging port on battery. The last and most important part about usage is battery and charging. Battery and charging. During charging, the battery indicator will light up in red. When charging is complete, the battery indicator will light up in blue. Charging. Please use the charger or adapter provided by the manufacturer. Each charge time is about 4 hours, with not more than 24 hours. Please charge in 24 hours when the low battery or the laser tool turns off due to low power. The best charging temperature, 0 degrees to 20 degrees. If the lithium battery is not used for extended time, please charge the lithium battery once every 3 months. Each charging time is not less than 6 hours. This is the end of the teaching explanation about the use of a L3OOHVG. If you have any questions or suggestions about the video content, please leave a comment under the video or send us an email. Thanks for watching.